But what we do have is like a sound idea in how to build sustainable businesses exactly. from scratch.
And
right?
we've all done it at really reputable names in the country. I mean, Vaishnavi is ex-Deloitte, I'm ex-PTM, Aparna is ex-Bank of America. And we've all been there where we have set up businesses, where we have grown teams, where we know how to grow from both 0 to 1 and 1 to 10.
Hey folks, welcome to First Check Portfolio Shorts. My name is Noah Martins and this is a series where we speak to founders of our portfolio companies so that you get to know their team, understand what they're building and the problem they're trying to solve. If you like the content that we've been putting out, do like, share and subscribe so that we can reach more founders and startup enthusiasts like you. Today's super special guests are Vaishnavi and Vishwanathan, co-founders of The Nestery. The Nestery is a community-led e-commerce marketplace for the modern parent. They are making parenting easier with proprietary, empathetic cataloging, curated products, and by leveraging the power of communities. I had a great conversation with Vaishnavi and Vishwanathan, and it is truly cool to see them doing so well, solving for a problem that they actually had. So do stick around till the end of the episode. Thank you both for joining me today. It is an honor to host you.
Our pleasure. I mean, really our pleasure.
So let's start by talking about the problem that you're trying to solve.
So introductions. I'm Vaishnavi. I am the co-founder of The Nestery.
I'm Vishwanathan. I'm also the co-founder of The Nestery.
So The Nestery actually came from a very deeply personal problem. I became a parent in 2015. I was very clueless. Yeah. Okay. I didn't know what to buy, when to buy, and why I should be buying what I should be buying, right? And my entire shopping experience for my child involved me tab jumping on my Chrome or, looking for the mythical unicorn within the larger marketplaces that are there. You know, I would know what I wanted, but I would never be able to find it. And that's when I really realized that discovery is a big problem in the space of maternity and childcare. And that is essentially the problem that we're solving at The Nestery. And that's why The Nestery was born.
All right. That's pretty cool. So talk to me about your solution. How did you solve this discovery
problem? I knew that discovery was a problem. I could have gone one or two ways. I could have just started a D2C brand that sort of covers ground in all things parenting and childcare. But that would mean that I really, really need very, very deep pockets. I took the route of starting a marketplace also because around the time when I was inspired to start The Nestery was when the D2C brand revolution was happening in India. So I actually remember the first samples of Super Bottoms Uno being, given out on Facebook groups that I was part of, right? I saw Moms Co. getting launched in front of my eyes. I saw Mama Earth getting launched like in a span of 2 months, it kind of blew up in all the parenting platforms that I was part of, right? So I realized that I'm discovering these amazing new brands every single day, but it's so hard to find them where people normally go to shop. And nobody is really telling why, it's all about just commerce, but there is no context to why a brand like Mama Earth or Moms Co. or Shumi or Super Bottoms or Skillmatics, why are they different from the others? Because these are brands that are putting their heart and soul into building a differentiation in the market, right? So that's why I chose to start a marketplace that kind of curates the D2C brands in the parenting and childcare space. Now, and that helps parents in discovering what to buy. Now, we also solve for discovery through, by working with influencers and communities, they have their own storefronts that kind of talk about the products. What it does for the end customer is it throws a very contextual nuance on whatever products that we curate. Right. Mm-hmm. We've also built our own cataloging system, which is proprietary to us, which basically focuses on what parents should buy and when they should buy it. Right. So discovery through context. So that's really what we're building, and that's our solution.
Amazing. Talk to me about your progress and about how y'all are different from me. Are there any other players in this space? And if so, how are y'all different? I understand y'all have a proprietary cataloging system. That's one thing. So yeah, if you could get into that.
Sure. So we have about 400 plus brands on our platform now. Nearly 50% of the brands, I mean, we've been on a really rapid growth trajectory. Right. Nearly 50% of these brands are brands that we've got on our platform the last about 6-7 months. We have about 62,000 paying customers now. And again, nearly about 80% of those customers have come onto our platform in the last about 5 or 6 months. And what really helps us believe in what we are building, it's just one of those metrics that keep reinforcing our own belief, is that 40%+ of our business comes from repeat customers regularly. And at such an early stage, having nearly just a little bit less than half your business coming from repeat customers, it just shows us that what we're building is very different, and it's what the customer needs. How are we different? I think Vaishnavi, you should cover it.
Yeah, how are we different? I actually kind of mentioned it to you. So every other player in the market, at least in the e-commerce space, is focused on e-commerce. Like, they may be building content, they may be having community. I'm not saying we also have that, but what we are consciously trying to build out from day one is context with e-commerce, which is exactly where every single one of our strategic pursuits has been, right? Be it building out proprietary algorithms for cataloging, or be it about starting our social commerce channel, where we work with influencers and parenting groups to create contextual recommendations for their audiences. So yeah, commerce with context. Terms of pure e-commerce competitors, I would say in the marketplace space, there is FirstCry. And Amazon is everyone's competitor, I guess. There is really actually no one else. So this is actually a wide open space. Also because we are targeting a very different TG from what the other larger incumbent players are targeting. So all in all, I think the way we are approaching e-commerce is very, very different. With a lot of heart and a lot of empathy. And yeah, so that's, yeah, commerce with context.
Yeah. In the end, I mean, I think we are building the business, we are building the e-commerce company that we wished we had when we were parents.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And what are each of your roles at? So I have I've seen a little bit of a glimpse of how you all operate, given that we've interacted before, but talk to me about your individual roles as co-founders and why people should want to be a part of your team.
Sure. So like I said, Vaishnavi, I cover. So we're actually a 3-member founding team, both of us being like the outward face of the Nestry. And an interesting fact, we are actually a husband and wife duo. But apart from that, our backgrounds are like, my background is from consulting. I used to work with Deloitte before I started the Nestry. TS actually has like more than a decade of fintech and financial services experience. And our third co-founder, Aparna, has, banking background. Like, all the three of us have, to be fair, we don't have e-commerce background. But what we do have is like a sound idea in how to build sustainable businesses from scratch.
And
we've
all done it at really reputable names in the country. I mean, Vaishnavi is ex-Deloitte, I'm ex-PTM, Aparna is ex-Bank of America. And we've all been there where we have set up businesses, where we have grown teams, where we know how to grow from both 0 to 1 and 1 to 10.
Right? Yeah.
For example, I set up, I was part of the team that set up merchant lending at Paytm. Right? She has brought lines of businesses which were there for Deloitte in the US as a practice area in India. Aparna has managed large mid-office and back-office shops for Bank of America. So it's just a lot of experience in team building and in growing businesses that we bring to the table.
Also, in terms of our internal roles, we've covered it pretty simply. I cover all things demand, which basically means marketing, branding, communications. I cover both the channel demands, right? Like growth for marketplace and growth for the social commerce channel. TS covers all things efficiency. Actually, you should talk about that.
Yeah. So I cover what is called as efficiency and capability. My job is to only ensure that Aparna and Vaishnavi are able to do their job well. So okay. I cover tech, I cover product, I cover finance, and I cover the overall strategy and
investor relations. And Aparna covers all things supply, which basically means that she's responsible for business development, getting the brands that we have, curation, is responsible for customer ops, vendor ops, and logistics, right? So that's the ground that she covers. Between the three of us, we cover all functions at the Nestle, and then we have a team that goes further below. Why should people really join our team? I think because we know how to build sustainable businesses from scratch. We believe that any business needs to be a profitable business, right? And that's really where we want to sort of build it towards. We are a team that has more than 80% parents. We have a majority of like women who've taken a break and rejoined their careers.
More than 70% of our workforce is women.
Yeah.
And nearly 60%, 60% people in our team are people who have taken a break at some point of time in their careers.
Yeah. And at this point, we are also fully remote. So we actually have people like, I can actually say all over the world, because we actually have folks sitting in Singapore who are working for us. So all in all, we're nice people to work with. I don't think that gets said often enough. And I think it's underrated. We're nice people to work with.
I believe you.
And that's why I think people should join our teams. And we, of course, the numbers do justice. We are growing really fast.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Thank you, folks, for taking the time to talk to me. It was really a pleasure. And it's very cool to see you all growing and to see your culture. So thanks.
Thank you, Noah. Thank you for hosting us.